half of Detroit schools are going to get shut down, half of them. And that's not even the most extreme part about it. Hey, it's January 18th, 2011. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Demcad. First, half of Detroit schools are going to get shut down, half of them. And that's not even the most extreme part about it. The most extreme part is that they're going to actually increase the class sizes in our high school to, wait for it, 62. Yeah, I had to read that article over and over again. They're going from about 35 to about 62. Unbelievable. Are they really going to try to cram that many kids into one classroom? It looks like that. It looks like they're going to try to do exactly that. But anyway, in international news, China's president said that, he was trying to be diplomatic, but he said that the U.S. dollar system, the world system in which the U.S. dollar is the dominant currency, is a thing of the past, which really got a lot of people's attention. But I think it's pretty obvious at this point. I mean, when you don't have any money and you're just printing money, does this cover the debt, the interest on your debt? I mean, come on. I mean, the show's pretty much over there. It's just a matter of how long it's going to take for the dollar to run its course. And what type of currencies are going to take its place. That's going to be the real, that's going to be a key. I think that's going to have to happen before the dollar really is something that's dumped. Also, there's a lot of stories about the economy and how CEOs, they did a survey and the CEOs, 41% of them said they're going to be hiring, and only 19% said they're going to be slashing jobs, which sounds really good, and I'd rather hear that than anything else, though. But, I mean, they're CEOs. I mean, you know, that could change with the wind. They're not exactly the most trustworthy people in the world, but, you know, it's better than nothing, I guess. I guess that's one way of looking at it. BP oil spill. Well, there's Obama had a commission on the Deepwater Horizon oil spill, and they were listening to people complain about their health problems. And one person said that his ethylbenzene levels were 2.5 times the 95 percentile, which sounds crazy. I mean, this person was worried about seeing his or her grandkids, and you know, I wouldn't blame that person. And it seems like the commission just sat there and listened to people talk about their health problems, but they're not really pushing to actually hold BP accountable. I mean, there's no real substance there. It sort of reminds me of, you know, a college's student development. Well, no, not student development, career development center, where it's just there to show people that, hey, yeah, we help you find jobs. But I mean, come on, in reality, it's just there for show. I mean, come on. In New Jersey, Camden is going to cut half of its police department and about a third of its fire department. They're looking at laying off one-fourth of their entire workforce, as many as 383 workers. Incredible. This is the second most dangerous city in the country. It's half of the city is living below the poverty line, and it's a mostly black and Hispanic population. You're going to see this all over the country. And I'm not trying to depress you guys, but, you know, I feel like it's my responsibility, if I'm going to be talking about this stuff, to provide an honest look at, you know, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And right now, there's a lot of bad. There's some good, but it's a lot of bad and even more ugly, so. And, of course, whenever there's a huge layoff, they always talk about the Guardian Angels, which is a volunteer group of civilians taken to the streets trying to help keep their neighborhood safe, which, you know, sounds good in theory, but that's going to be a rough assignment, okay? I want my guardian angel to have a SIG or a Glock or a Springfield XD or something, okay? I want my guardian to have a flashlight. Just a flashlight, sorry. Some people have some comments for me, and I'm going to respond to them. Why all the negative news stories? There are some positive stories out there. I know people just like negative stories, and you're trying to get your page views, but come on, every once in a while, a positive story wouldn't kill you. Well, first of all, I think this guy needs to watch the Cartoon Network, because you know, if you want me to blow smoke up your ass, this is the wrong channel. All right. Last time, I did have a positive news story. I thought the riots in Tunisia was a pretty good story to me, because at least the people were fighting back against a government that didn't represent their interests. I mean, if that's not a good news story, I don't know what is. I like the replies, though. Somebody said, there's always Sesame Street.
Here's some good news for you. Holiday spending hits an all-time record of $462 billion. Okay, this is more than a $453 billion peak that we saw in 2007. I'm not sure if this is really good news. Since our problem in this country isn't really spending, but it's really debt. But but anyway, we have added 8 million more people to the economy since then. So naturally, you would see an increase if you're always getting an increase of people, a substantial increase of people. It doesn't really factor in inflation and all that. That's something that's never really factored in. And of course, gold and silver has been increasing pretty well in the last few years. So I'm not sure that $462 billion of 2010 is worth the $453 billion of 2007. So,
okay, somebody also asked me, you know, what are my long-term plans with the collapse or something? You know, if there is a collapse, what do I plan on doing? Because my preparations seem to be very short-term. Well, hopefully the seeds will help me out for the long-term. But my plan is originally planned for about a three-month disruption period, a period where there's an emergency and basic resources aren't available. And by doing that, I want to keep myself off the streets and out of trouble. So whatever happens, just happens, and I'll wait till things blow over, and I'll start from there. That's pretty much the strategy I have based on the amount of money I have and the expertise I have and, well, expertise and knowledge I have. So what are your plans if things do go south? With the economy, with a dollar collapse or whatever, or any other type of natural emergency, if there's a situation where the grid goes down. Also, somebody wanted to know, well, how come I'm not rioting? I'm not really convinced that rioting is the most productive way of dealing with the problems we have right now. I think the best thing to do is just to let this unsustainable system fall apart and then position yourself to have a positive influence on the new system that people work to create. Because I don't think you can reform this system. I think it's a system that's going to have to collapse. And people aren't going to let go of it until it falls apart. I could be wrong, but what do you guys think? All right, have a good day. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. All right, bye.